Grade 8, Unit 9, the human skin. So you know the largest organ of our body is skin. So it is actually giving protection to our body. It consists of two layers, that is epidermis and dermis. So here the epidermis and dermis. So when you see the skin structure, so this is the skin structure. So you know the outermost layer up to this layer, that is epidermis, and inner layer we call dermis. This is epidermis, this is dermis, and here there is a hypodermis at the bottom. It consists fat deposits. So these are the actually the main layers are epidermis and dermis. So when you see the epidermis, the outermost layer with the dead cells, that means dead cells, the outermost layer become dead cells, that is removed from our body continuously. When you are bathing or rubbing your skin, that dead cells removed from your body, and newborn cells at the bottom, newly the cells born, and that also when it comes up it become dead cells. Like that the cells cell bone happen continuously in the epidermis. Then there is inside the dermis, when you compare, so there are many parts here. One is the skin is acting as a sensory organ. So due to that there are nerve endings present in the dermis. There are five types of senses felt by the skin, that is touch, pressure, pain, cold and hot. There are five senses recognized by feel by skin. So there are different types of nerve endings are here in the skin, dermis. So that's why the skin is acting as a sensory organ. So the other one you can see here, hair. So the hair is that is produced from the hair follicle here. This is the basement of the hair, that is the hair follicle. So the hair is here. You know the mammals, human is a mammal, the body is surrounded by hairs in the skin. So actually the hair also helping to regulate our body temperature. So next one, there are sweat glands. Here you can see the sweat glands. So there are many blood capillaries. Here you can see underneath of the skin. So when the environmental temperature increases or decreases, the blood supply to the skin changes. Therefore, that will regulate the body temperature. I'll explain to you the first one. So here when the environmental temperature increases, the sweat gland produce more sweat. Sweat gland produce more sweat and the excess heat will loss with the sweat. So sweat glands also regulate the body temperature. And you know here sebaceous gland, here actually the secretion keep our skin moisture. Always keep the other one, it helps our skin from microbial act, right? So when the microorganisms make some defect in the skin, that will destroy the, that secretion destroy the microorganisms. So these are the main parts in the dermis. And this is fat deposits. You know when the people who live in cold areas have more fat deposit here to protect keeping the body with more heat. Without heat loss, the fat deposits help here, helps, right? So these are the this is the structure of skin. Now we will see with explain. So you know the epidermis, epidermis and dermis. Epidermis, dead cells present in the outermost layer. I told you, when the newly born cells become after sometimes dead cells, so the dead cells are removed from our body continuously. So the epidermis, there is a pigment called melanin pigment. Actually, melanin pigment is more, the skin become darker. So the melanin pigment is an advantage because it protect our body from ultraviolet rays in the sun. The sun rays, there is a type of ray, ultraviolet rays. So that is actually harmful rays. So the if melanin pigment is there, that will protect our skin from the ultraviolet rays. Then after that, newborn cells form continuously in the epidermis. So the dead cells, melanin pigment and newborn cells, those are in the epidermis. Dermis, it contains hair follicle where the hair produce. Nerve endings, I told you the five types of senses we can feel: cold, hot, pressure, pain, touch. Sweat glands is there, so that it regulate our body temperature. Sebaceous gland, keeping skin moist and protect our body from microbial act, and the blood capillaries are there. So the functions of the human skin. First, protection. You know, the melanin pigment protect our skin from the ultraviolet rays, prevent from dehydration. The skin won't allow the water to lose our body more, so that is regulate. And sebaceous gland, I told you, act against to microorganism. So therefore the skin acts as a protective organ. Then regulation of body temperature. You know, human is a that we call warm-blooded animal. Warm-blooded animal means our body temperature should be constant always. That is 37 Celsius. So when the environmental temperature increases or decreases, our body temperature regulated by some actions. Now, when the environmental temperature increases, what happened? Our body temperature also increase. So what happened? The excess heat should be removed from our body. So the excess heat in the body released out by sweating. So when the environmental temperature increases, so the sweat glands produce more sweat. And what happened? That is released from our body. At that time, the heat also lost, excess heat also lost from our body, so the body become to normal temperature. Like that, when the environmental temperature decreases, the cold seasons, so our body temperature also comes down. At that time, the heat should be produced into your body. So what happened? The blood capillaries in the skin contract means that is shrink. So what happened? The blood won't supply to the skin more. So here, see, the blood capillaries are here. When the environmental temperature become less whole season, so the blood capillaries contract, shrinks. So what happened? The water in the blood won't diffuse to the sweat gland. So the sweat gland can't produce more sweat. So sweating decreases at that time. So it prevents heat lost from our body. So that is happening. And the shivering also the same thing. When shivering, the heat produced in our body. At that time, the hair also come to erect. In the cold season, it come to erect to trap some hair here. It traps some air between the hairs, so that also won't allow to heat lose from our body. So next one, acting as a sensory organ. I told you the five types of nerve endings are there. That is cold, hot, touch, pressure and pain, to feel the senses. and synthesis of vitamin D. That is, skin uses sun rays and produce vitamin D. Excretion. Earlier I told you the sweat glands are secrete sweat, which has urea, uric acid little, and salt with water, sodium chloride with water. This we studied in excretion. So these are the some functions of the human skin. So maintaining a healthy skin, taking diet with nutrition, always you have to eat vitamins A and E to protect your skin, and drinking fresh water. Keep the skin clean, you have to bathe daily 2 or 3 times, and using clean clothes. Protect from the sun, then only you can protect your skin from UV rays. Avoid smoking and smokers. That also, you should not stand near the smokers, because smoke reduces the blood circulation. It reduces the blood circulation in your body, so it loses the skin and it loses the strength. Wearing cotton dresses, because we are living in a tropical, that is hot area, therefore we have to wear cotton dresses. Do not share your dresses with others. If some other people, the other friends or sisters like that, they are having some diseases, skin diseases, you also get that. Manage stress, mental stress, and get medical advice for your skin disorders. If you are getting any skin diseases or disorders, you have to get medical advice. So skin disorders, pityriasis, then removal of skin, warts, acne, heel getting dry, eczema. So in your textbook we are having some pictures for these diseases, you can note it. So this is the human skin. So we are finishing unit 9.